Let's look at and try to explain the outcome of the following two-step sequence where we react a carbonyl compound like this one right here with sodium hydroxide, and then we follow that up by neutralizing the solution with acid. And what we get back is shown over here. You'll see we started with one enantiomer of this carbonyl compound. We end up with a mixture of both enantiomers. And as I said, we want to try to explain this result. And the important thing to recognize and understand in explaining this result is the structure of the product we get from this first step, the reaction of the sodium hydroxide with our carbonyl compound. And as you might expect, sodium hydroxide being a base looks for a hydrogen in this carbonyl compound to remove. And it finds two different sets of acidic hydrogens, one on this alpha carbon and three on this alpha carbon. We're not going to worry about the three on this alpha carbon because they don't really affect the process we're studying. We are going to look at what happens when we take the alpha hydrogen from this carbon. I've shown the R isomer of my carbonyl compound here, and I also have a 3D model of it here. Here's my carbonyl, the methyl group. This is the hydrogen we're removing. I've coated it blue so that we can keep track of it. Now, when the base removes this hydrogen, the first thing that we get is this anion. And it's really important that we look at the structure of this anion. And I'm going to do it over here first. So first thing that happens is the base comes and takes this hydrogen. So this hydrogen is gone. But the structure of this molecule doesn't stay like this. This methyl group starts to move down like this because this carbon is going to become sp3, and it was sp3 hybridized. It's going to become sp2 hybridized, and we're going to get a planar center here, and that's really important in this whole process. And this sp2 carbon has a p orbital on it that's actually in conjugation with this carbonyl compound, or I should say this carbonyl group. And since it's conjugated to this carbonyl group, I can also actually over here draw another resonance structure for this molecule like this. And I can show that other resonance structure over here as well. And you can see in this resonance structure, all three p orbitals on all three of the atoms in our conjugated system are overlapping. Now, I want to focus on this first resonance structure and trying to explain these two products, because what happens in the second step is when we add the acid, the H plus that's donated by this acid can come in to this anion from either the top face as shown here, and I'm showing this is the hydrogen atom, the electron density is in this p orbital, and the hydrogen is coming in from the top face, which will give me the S isomer of my carbonyl compound, or the hydrogen can come in from the, as I've drawn it here, the bottom face, giving me back the isomer that I started with. So the key to understanding this process is the fact that this intermediate carbonyl anion, carbanion, is planar. This is sp2 center. It's planar. Then the hydrogen that gets added during our acidification step can come in from either face of the molecule, giving us a mixture of enantiomers.